Clara Barton's heroic efforts to administer timely and compassionate care to wounded soldiers on the front lines of the American Civil War battlefields was an act of devotion to her father and country that became the fulfillment of her search for a life purpose. After her work serving soldiers on the battlefield, and then their families, searching for missing loved ones, Clara's strong desire to serve humanity in any way possible led to her tireless efforts in founding the American Red Cross. On December 25, 1821, Clarissa Harlow Barton was born in North Oxford, Massachusetts. She was the fifth child of Captain Stephen and Sarah Stone Barton. Clara's devotion to her father began at an early age as he told her the many stories of the Barton family's long line of military service. She fondly called him Soldier Father and greatly admired his service to his country during the Indian Wars. She was somewhat neglected being the youngest in a busy household, but was tutored by her siblings.
Clara Barton's older brother, David Barton, fell from a barn roof. He fell and was injured and bedridden for about 2 years. And during that time, Clara Barton was his nursemaid.
When tragedy struck the Barton household in the form of her brother David's accidental fall, Clara, at the age of 12, began what would become a lifetime of compassionate care as she nursed her brother back to health.
There are some contradictions in her character. On the one hand, she was very shy and quiet, especially as a child. But also, clearly, she became a very brave lady.
For the next 15 years, Miss Barton reformed one classroom after another throughout Massachusetts and was responsible for starting the first free public school in Bordentown, New Jersey. She finally quit the teaching profession when, due to the discrimination against women in that day, Clara was passed over as superintendent of the free school that she founded in favor of a man. In 1855, Clara Barton becomes the first woman to work for a government office when she is hired to work for the Patent Office in Washington, D.C. On April 12, 1861, the American Civil War begins with the firing on Fort Sumter, South Carolina. It is from the Patent Office that Clara is first able to see the devastating effects of war on the Union Army soldiers as they begin to pour into Washington after being wounded in the Battle of Bull Run. Miss Barton's love for soldiers and her strong desire to be of service causes her to begin to collect supplies to help care for the needs of the wounded men, many of whom were former students of hers in Massachusetts. She was angered that the injured soldiers were not well cared for. She felt called to help. But her insecurities would hold her back. One historian noted that she was afraid to pursue helping on the battlefield because she was an unmarried woman. In Clara Barton's biography, A Woman of Valor, Stephen B. Oates writes of Captain Barton's commanding words to his daughter on his deathbed. The old man raised himself up on his pillow and told her, "I know soldiers, and they will respect you and your errand." Even the roughest of them, he assured her, would show respect to a respectable woman. Then her father commanded her to go. He reminded her that she was the daughter of an accepted Mason and a Universalist, and that it was her duty on both counts to seek and comfort the afflicted everywhere. Above all, she was the daughter of a soldier and a patriot, and he charged me with a dying patriot's love, Clara remembered, to serve and sacrifice for my country in its peril, and strengthen and comfort the brave men who stood for its defense. Now all Clara needed was the Union Army's approval. With the persistence she would later apply to founding the American Red Cross, Clara went from one Army official to the next to get permission to join the wounded on the battlefield with the many supplies and provisions she had gathered for them. She was first granted favor by Colonel Daniel H. Rucker after crying and pleading to him for help. When he heard that she had three warehouses full of supplies, he eagerly gave her the passage she needed to get to the front lines of the Army of Virginia, along with wagons to carry her provisions. On August 9, 1862, the Battle of Cedar Mountain, Virginia began. This is the first recorded battle at which Clara serves on the field. She spent 2 days and nights caring for the wounded. This would be the first of more than a dozen battles and conflicts. At the Battle of Antietam, Clara proved to be as brave and as selfless as ever. It was customary for the medical units to arrive at the back of the army ranks, but Clara saw how necessary it was for medical care to be at the front in order to save more lives.
Clara Barton's role here at the Battle of Antietam was a very important one, because the Battle of Antietam was fought in 1862, and this is before the Army Medical Corps was really very organized. So there wasn't a lot of quality medical care for the Union soldiers. When Clara Barton came along, she came as a volunteer, and she showed up at this battlefield with two wagons full of medical supplies, food, blankets, clothing, specifically to provide nursing care for the soldiers from her home state of Massachusetts. And she actually operated in the barn that we're standing in right now. You know, when you visit Antietam National Battlefield Park today, it's a very peaceful, tranquil, serene place. It's hard to imagine what it was like here on the day of the battle. And it's even harder to imagine what it must have been like for a civilian, a woman, Clara Barton, to come here in the midst of all this fighting to help these soldiers. Just imagine what it was like for her. She's in possibly the very stall that we're in right now, helping to nurse wounded soldiers. There are cannon shells exploding everywhere, wounded men lying everywhere, smoke, fire, destruction, confusion. Clara Barton is so close to the action that when she's out on the field, she's helping a soldier who's been wounded, and a bullet passes right through the sleeve of her garment and kills the soldier that she's giving aid to. That's how close Clara Barton was to the combat.
For the next 3 years, Barton found herself on the battlefield caring for the sick and wounded. She and her wagons delivered supplies, tended to the wounded, assisted the surgeons, prepared the injured for evacuation to hospitals, and arranged for the opening of private homes for care of the wounded. She became the angel of the battlefield to so many sick and wounded soldiers in their darkest hour. Clara's compassion for soldiers of the Civil War did not end with the conclusion of the battles. She won the approval of President Abraham Lincoln to create the Office of Correspondence with Friends of the Missing Men of the United States Army on March 11, 1865. The Office of Correspondence was the first government office held by a woman. Clara did brave, selfless acts of service during the Civil War that amazed the men around her. But Clara was only happy when she was in the middle of a great cause. She would slip into a deep depression when she was no longer needed or useful. Her diaries record suicidal thoughts and great despair in between one project and the next. Only another compassionate cause serving humanity would fill the void in Clara's life. Clara once again discovers a purpose for her life and spends the next decade convincing the American people to join the Geneva Convention and to create the American Red Cross. On May 21, 1881, the American Association of the Red Cross was formed, electing Clara Barton as its president, and a year later, President Chester A. Arthur signed the Treaty of Geneva and the U.S. joins the International Red Cross. Clara was not satisfied with the Red Cross simply responding in wartime, but used the resources of the Red Cross to help people all around the country in times of catastrophe.
There's something about Clara Barton that is typically American, and that is, Clara Barton was here as a volunteer. Volunteerism is a typically American phenomenon.
She died alone in her home in Maryland on April 12, 1912, at the age of 90, and is buried in the family cemetery in Oxford, Massachusetts. Today, because of Clara Barton and her tireless devotion to serve our country, the American Red Cross continues to help people all over the world receive aid in every kind of catastrophe. You must never so much think as whether you like it or not, whether it is bearable or not. You must never think of anything except the need and how to meet it.